In the previous video, we started our discussion of the depletion region of the p-n junction under illumination. We looked at the carrier concentration in the p-n junction at thermal equilibrium and under uniform generation of charge carriers. Under uniform photogeneration condition, generation of carriers can occur in the depletion region as well as in the quasi-neutral regions. The carriers generated in the quasi-neutral regions will move around through diffusion. Holes and electrons generated in the depletion region will be swept to the p-type and n-type regions respectively due to the drift caused by the internal electric field. The electrons and holes in the quasi-neutral regions that are close enough to the depletion region will eventually reach the depletion region. Here they will experience electrical force that will act on them. Again, electrons that reach the depletion region will move to the N site and holes to the P site. As the minority carriers at the depletion region are swept away, this decreases the concentration of these carriers at the edge. This induces a concentration gradient, and minority carriers further away from the depletion region will diffuse towards the depletion region and eventually continue to be swept away. In general, only the photogenerated minority charge carriers that are within the diffusion length from the depletion region edge will be drifted across the depletion region. Ln is the diffusion length of electrons in the p-type region, and Lp is the diffusion length of holes in the n-type region. The minority carriers generated far away from the edges of the depletion region will recombine before reaching the depletion region. So, due to an enormous increase in the concentration of minority charge carriers, the drift current across the depletion region will increase. Electrons will be pushed from the p-type region to the n-type region, and holes the other way around, from the n-type region to the p-type region. You can imagine that the drift current of photogenerated minority carriers across the depletion region will not increase indefinitely, but will reach a steady state. The collection of photogenerated minority carriers in the regions where they become majority carriers is increasing the concentration of majority carriers above the equilibrium value. A system, in our case the p-n junction diode, tends to go back to the original state, so at a certain moment the diffusion of majority carriers will balance the increased drift across the depletion region. At steady state, however, the concentration of majority carriers exceeds the equilibrium value. It means that the concentration of negatively charged electrons in the n-type quasi-neutral region is not anymore compensated by the ionized donors. Similarly, the concentration of positive charged holes in the p-type quasi-neutral region is not anymore compensated by the ionized acceptors. The average energy of electrons is expressed by the position of electron quasi-Fermi level and will be higher at the electrode attached to the n-type region with respect to the electrode attached to the p-type region. The buildup of positive and negative charge in the opposite quasi-neutral regions generates an electrochemical difference, electrochemical potential difference between the electrodes attached to the p-n junction under illumination. This generation of photovoltage, that is called open circuit voltage, is the consequence of the photovoltaic effect as we mentioned before. To summarize, under illumination, charge carriers are generated in the p-n junction. The minority charge carriers that diffuse towards the depletion region will be drifted through the depletion region. Electrons will drift towards the n-type region and holes towards the p-type region, respectively, where they become majority charge carriers. These extra photogenerated majority charge carriers build up a negative charge in the N-type material and a positive charge in the P-type material. The resulting potential difference is in the opposite direction of the internal electric field across the depletion region. The internal electric field is therefore decreased, and consequently also the width of the depletion region. This will lower the drift current across the depletion region as well. When the diffusion and drift currents are once again balanced, the depletion region width stops changing and a steady state is achieved. At this steady state, an electrochemical potential difference exists between the N-type and P-type regions.
When there is no external electrical contact between the electrodes attached to N-type and P-type regions, or when the resistance of the load in the external circuit is infinite, there is no current flowing in the external circuit. We call this situation that the PN junction diode is in the open circuit condition. Under open circuit condition, we measure the open circuit voltage between the electrodes that represents the difference of electrochemical potential of electrons at the electrodes. Inside the diode, there is a steady state that is characterized by generation and recombination of photogenerated charge carriers and the balance between the diffusion currents of majority carriers and the drift currents of photogenerated minority carriers across the depletion region. When we connect the P-type and N-type region together with a good conductor, we create a short circuit condition. In this case, electrons will move from the N-type region via the external circuit to the P-type region. The electrons flow from the region where they have a higher energy to the region where they will be at a lower energy. So now you understand what happens when a PN junction is under illumination. In the following lecture, we will see the band diagrams and electrostatic potential of a PN junction under illumination in different points of operation.